Hi, it's Katrina. From having their own language to hunting down great white sharks, these mega marine mammals are at the top of the food chain. Here are 7 things you didn't know about killer whales. Number 7. Why is the killer whale called an orca? Both of the names come from the fear that this animal has instilled into our human hearts over the centuries. Their scientific name, Orcinus Orca, comes from the mythical Orcus. You may not have heard much about him, but he was the Roman god of death and the underworld, and the punisher of broken promises. The genus Orcinus means belonging to Orcus. In Latin, orca also translates to large-bellied pot or jar, but orc also refers to a whale. So, a large whale in the shape of a jar belonging to the mythical punisher god of death seems appropriate. I mean, we all know about their incredible hunting skills, and their reputation is getting more and more ferocious. So why are they called killer whales? It is thought not because they look like whales, but because sailors and whalers would see them killing whales and eating them. I guess their name changed over time from whale killers to the more natural killer whale. Number 6. Killer whales can't smell. The killer whale has very well-developed eyesight. The convex or spherical lens of marine mammals differs vastly from those of land mammals. A marine mammal's eyes compensate for the lack of refraction at the cornea interface by having a more powerful spherical lens. Killer whales also have a well-developed acute sense for hearing underwater, and they process sounds at a much higher speed than humans. They can hear each other from more than 10 miles away. Studies have also shown that their sense of touch is very well developed, and the most sensitive areas include areas around the eyes and mouth and the blowhole region. They emit a wide variety of communicative sounds, and they use echolocation to communicate and hunt. This means that they make noises and sounds that travel underwater until they encounter objects, then bounce back, revealing the size, position, and shape of the object to the orca. This may also be why there are no attacks on humans. Unlike sharks, who might mistake us for a seal and take an exploratory bite, orcas are able to detect our shape and learn more about us much more quickly to know that we are not what they are looking for. All toothed whales lack the olfactory lobes of the brain, as well as the olfactory nerves themselves, which indicates that they have no sense of smell whatsoever. Seeing as they live underwater, they have no real need for the sense of smell, and this tends to be why all their other senses are exceptionally well developed. Some people also believe that killer whales have a sixth sense. They will avoid hunters even if they have traveled the same route for hundreds of years, and they will do something fantastic right when the photographers and killer whale watchers have put their cameras away or their battery has just died. And now for number 5. But first, do you know why orcas are black and white? Leave your answer in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe if you're new here. We have lots of new videos coming up. Number 5. Hunting strategies. Like I've said before, orcas are smart. They are highly social and hunt in coordinated packs. Their ingenuity and predatory intelligence is passed down from one generation to the next. Orcas will adapt their strategies according to their prey. They use echolocation to find their prey, sending out sonar clicks that bounce back to them, and once they locate the target, it is on. When hunting for fish, orcas will surround a school into a tight-knit group and then blast bubbles at them or hit them with their tails to stun them and then take turns picking out the fish. This is known as carousel fishing. Tuna is another favorite food, but tuna are very, very fast. Orcas will often just chase tuna around until the fish gets exhausted, not really trying to catch it so that they have enough energy to actually eat it. For larger tuna, orcas will tag team to chase it down, or just steal the fish from fishermen's nets. Orcas love to prey on young gray whale calves. In an attempt to save them, the mother will try to go to shallow water, but before then, the orcas will grab the whales and try to drag them to deeper water and then take turns holding them down until they drown. The problem is that if the whale drowns in water that is too deep, the orcas won't be able to feed. So again, they work together to keep the carcass towards the surface and take turns feeding. If they make a kill in deep water, they will go for the most interesting organs and parts, like the tongue. This probably explains why so many great white sharks wash up missing their livers. But I'll tell you more about that. If you've seen Planet Earth or National Geographic documentaries, you've probably seen orcas beaching themselves on the shore with a bunch of seals, scaring them into the water. Too bad for them, the rest of the pod is lying in wait beneath the waves, ready to grab any that pass by. other orcas will toss them into the air to make them more vulnerable to attack. A video captured by a whale-watching company called Eagle Wing Tours and its video production company, Roll Focus Productions, in British Columbia, captured a killer whale hitting a seal with its tail and punting it about 80 feet into the air. They prefer to debilitate their prey before trying to eat them. In very cold climates like the Antarctic Peninsula, they have developed the wave wash. Seals will perch on ice floes to stay out of reach, but generations of orcas have now perfected the technique of charging at an ice floe in a tight formation, then at the last minute, diving underneath the ice, creating a wave that sweeps the seal off. If you have time, you can watch this on BBC's Frozen Planet series. They have about an 86% success rate. Did I mention they also eat moose? Try to figure out how they manage that. Number 4. Do they live up to their name? Orcas aren't whales themselves. They belong to the dolphin family, Delphinidae, and it is the largest of all the dolphins. Whalers working off the coast of Australia claimed that killer whales would help them hunt other whales. They are also known for hunting pretty much anything regardless of size, including great white sharks. The scary thing is that when a pod of about 30 to 100 orcas comes together, nobody stands a chance. They love to eat seals, sea lions, squid, narwhals, gray whales, dolphins, and of course, fish and birds too. Orcas are highly sophisticated and intelligent creatures, and a pod will work together using all kinds of strategies and techniques, which I just told you about. Rudiger Reich, a scientist at the University of London, points out that marine mammals have very sharp claws and teeth, so it is safer for orcas to debilitate them first before getting them anywhere near their face. So they will use a combination of headbutts, rams, and slapping prey with their tail fins. Their brutal attacks on innocent little whale calves and narwhal breeding grounds, and the fact that they like to play with their food before eating it, makes them kind of scary. Scientists in Canada also witnessed two orca whales killing one of their own calves. They said they were horrified and fascinated at the same time, as it was the first recorded instance of an orca killing a calf of the same species. So, is it deserving of the name killer whale? What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Number 3. Killer whales have a unique dialect. Killer whales, just like all aquatic mammals, depend heavily on underwater sound for orientation, feeding, and communication. There are three different categories of music that killer whales produce: clicks, whistles, and pulsed calls. Clicks are commonly heard during social interactions, but are also mainly used for navigating and locating prey and other possible obstacles in the surrounding environment. Transient killer whales are typically silent and sometimes use a single click called a cryptic click rather than the customarily used long train of clicks. Family members of a resident pod use similar calls, which are collectively known as a dialect. These dialects are composed of specific numbers and types of discrete and repetitive calls. Within the matrilines, the call patterns and structure are very distinctive. An individual's dialect is learned through contact with its mother and other pod members. Dialects seem to be an essential way to maintain group identity and cohesiveness. The similarity in dialects can reflect the degree of relatedness between pods. The killer whale's dialect not only differs between pods, but also between types. The frequency of a killer whale's whistle ranges from about 0.5 kHz to 40 kHz. Pulsed calls are, however, the most common vocalization by the killer whales. Pretty advanced stuff, right? Number 2. Great white shark versus the killer whale. It's very hard to imagine the terrifying great white shark as prey. In 2017, beachgoers were horrified to stumble across the carcasses of great white sharks washed up on the beaches in South Africa. These bodies ranged in size from as small as 9 feet to as big as 16 feet, but they all had large sets of puncture marks behind their pectoral fins. What was eating the apex predator of the sea? Scientists discovered that whoever murdered these 5 great white sharks knew exactly where to bite in order to get what they were hunting for – their livers. It was determined that since a great white shark can detect a drop of blood in 25 gallons of water from 3 miles away, the only possible suspects that could pose such a danger to these predators were indeed the aptly named killer whales. The great whites are not likely to rival the orcas, as they tend to be a bit smaller in size, and although they can attack in short bursts at high speeds, the orcas can sustain their high speeds much longer. It was determined that the culprits of these killings had to be the killer whale due to the size of the bite marks found on the bodies of the sharks. If you compare these two predators, it would look something like this. Average length of a great white shark, 15 to 20 feet, weight around 3 tons. Average length of a killer whale, 23 to 32 feet, weight of up to 10 tons. Plus, they work together, giving them an enormous advantage. However, it was always believed that these apex predators stayed out of each other's way. So what happened? Killer whales are adapting to changing ocean temperatures and conditions and figured out that the great white's liver is delicious and nutritious. It is high in lipids, full of oil, protein, and vitamins. So how do they get the liver out with surgical-like precision? Observations were documented of an orca slamming into a great white shark off the coast of San Francisco in 1997. The force of this blow stunned the shark enough to give the orca the opportunity to flip the shark over. As if it were an expert in marine biology, it put the great white into tonic immobility, giving the orca the power to essentially drown the great white shark and bite out its liver. So when these titans of the sea clash, the orca is faster, stronger, bigger, and hunts in groups. The great white is no longer safe. Did you guess why orcas were black and white? Scientists believe that their coloring helps camouflage them in the water. It is hard for their prey to see them at different angles, although it doesn't seem like they need it since they are apex predators after all. There are most likely other evolutionary advantages that we just don't know about yet. Number 1. Orcas and humans. While so far their behavior may seem intimidating and violent, it is important to note that many Native American tribes respected the killer whale and believed they were a special protector of humankind. Killer whales were symbolic animals representative of mightiness and vigor, qualities aspired to by warriors. They were referred to as the lords of the ocean and would protect the waters with the help of dolphins. They travel in large groups, and some tribes believe them to be reincarnated ancestors, representing the strong bonds of family. While they are respected for their power and liveliness, because of the brutal way that they hunt and kill, they are also feared. Orcas are curious and always eager to explore new things, so when they follow boats and surfers, it makes people nervous. However, on maybe a surprising note, orcas have been said to protect humans as well as other wildlife from sharks. Orcas do not kill humans at sea. Killer whales don't hang out where people swim, and the only deaths caused by them have been in captivity. In his book, The Killer Whale Who Changed the World, author Mark Liren Young says that killer whales have helped humans to hunt fish and whales in North America and Australia for years. In the late 19th century, orcas near Eden, Australia would drive humpback whales into the bay to the fishermen's boats in exchange for the tongue and the lips of the whale. It was known as the Law of the Tongue. When the boats were sometimes capsized by the whales, the orcas would protect the fishermen from sharks until they could get to safety. Orcas like tender, soft flesh, and we are just not on the menu. Some researchers believe that orcas have very elaborate behaviors and each pod has its own form of society. Perhaps it is a social norm to not eat people, for now, depending on how we treat them. In captivity, orcas get bored and restless, but trainers at aquatic parks believe that the attacks are not malicious, just playfulness getting out of hand. Other researchers say it might not be in cold blood, but that orcas in parks cut off from their pods and confined to such a small space are going to lash out. In any case, in the wild, there have been very few reported attacks and no fatalities. While orcas are an apex predator, they are not considered endangered, but fishermen around the world consider them as pests since they compete with them for their catch, and they are hunted by certain countries around the world for their meat. Other small populations around the world are considered endangered as their food supply begins to run out and their water is contaminated by human waste. Thanks for watching! I hope you learned something new about this impressive animal. Be sure to subscribe before you leave, and I'll see you next time! Bye!